Greetings from the University of Texas at El Paso. Sorry I'm unable to be with you in person, but I hope you're enjoying this evening we organized, and I'm excited to read some poems from my poetry folder being published this month in Journal of Humanistic Mathematics. My first poem relates my first conjecture after making the crimson LED digits dance on my new calculator. It's called Discovery. I stumble upon the sum of the first cubes, always a square. As a middle schooler, did I discover a true, new result? And if so, will people value the lesser theorem? Dad unsure of originality, we visit Mr. Peaceman, an engineer friend whose CRC reveals pages of identities, yielding validation and awe of how much further the frontier. The next poem is called L'Hôpital. Calc 101 teaches that L'Hôpital's rule doesn't always resolve indeterminate forms. In the example shown, applying the rule repeatedly to the limit at infinity of u over the square root of u squared plus 1 only flips the fraction. On paper, L'Hôpital looks like La Hospital, and the hospital is the setting of this poem, written before I knew a family member would be okay. With health, it's all how you group the operations, the functions of the body, fracturing into a fraction calling for La Hospital. There, confusion reigns beyond change of shift. One nurse writes NPO. Another says, sure, you can eat. And each person who enters starts by asking about allergies, surgeries, and family history. Each test a bottleneck of waiting for the one who can authorize, organize, supervise, analyze, and then advise, often only leading to needing another sample or image. So far, it's indeterminate. What's still possible is anything from zero to infinity. False positive, life-changing disease, or anything in between. Now a friend asks how it's going. My tongue finds no one word to sum up how pain's controlled, but not the fear, the frustration with La Hospital, that I pray, being between all and nothing, is nearing closure, not making rounds, like the limit at infinity of x over the square root of 1 plus x squared. My poem Julia is about my paternal grandmother. Julia set in motion my journey in mathematics. For a quarter century, my grandmother taught math with distinction in the public schools of Fort Worth. Driving up to Colorado for my first professorship, Dad and I stop at her grave. Reflect on how Julia set a tone, left a legacy. In our family of complex dynamics, a tiny perturbation could yield big changes. Surely the enrichment gems she'd mailed me over my youth made such a shift in my intellect. A perturbation no less important was how Julia set aside gender roles. She was an athlete in her youth and later coached baseball teams of each gender. A former student wrote my dad, "Your mother taught the girls we could be savvy in math right alongside the boys. Your mother opened up the ordered universe for us. I can still see the chalk flying when she hit the board in a frenzy of excitement." I close with a 12-second poem inspired by thinking about an inverse function as playing a movie in reverse. The poem is called "The Algebra Teacher Writes in Verse." Triple X, then add 5, then divide by 2. Label that, answer Y, now let's flip the view. Double Y, take off 5, third makes deja vu. Thank you very much.